Here's to key lime pie. My lips are so chapped! Hey, what is up, guys? It is Michael, and welcome to episode 1 of Cooking with Michael. Unless you're a true fan, then this is like episode 3.5. But we're starting over, so this is episode 1. Welcome! Today, we're gonna be making some fun little key lime pies in these mini mason jars for you to display because they're cute and share with your friends.
This is voice my 1 week on Bellalathorn.
So let's get started. For this recipe, you're going to need graham crackers, sugar, salted butter, cream cheese, condensed milk, heavy whipping cream, powdered sugar, and of course, some limes. First, we're gonna take a half a cup of graham crackers and we're gonna crush them. So I wasn't really sure how to measure graham crackers in cups, but I looked online and apparently 2.25 ounces of graham crackers is a half a cup. So I have this nice little scale and we're gonna measure 2.25 grams of graham crackers. That's 2.7, that's close enough. That is approximately 5 graham crackers. But anyways, we're going to now put this. Oh, I broke that. So we're gonna put this in a Ziploc bag. We're gonna seal the Ziploc bag. And we're gonna take this rolling pin and we're just gonna smush them. This is a great way to relieve stress. So if you're feeling angry, just let it out on the graham cracker crumbs. Nice. Once you have your fun little bag of graham cracker crumbs, you're gonna pour them out into a mixing bowl. And then you're gonna take 2 tablespoons of sugar and add it to the mixing bowl. And just to mix those ingredients together, you're gonna take a fork and you're just gonna whoosh around the bowl. So once you're done, hi mom. So once you're done mixing your graham cracker sugar bowl, you're gonna put it to the side and we're gonna measure out 2 tablespoons of salted butter. And we're gonna melt it. Fun fact, this little microwave that you see behind me is recently broken. So we're going to attempt to use the oven. So I have the stove.
You, are you dumb?
And I just put the butter
in a nonstick pan.
And we're gonna take it over to the stove. We're gonna turn it on
low
heat, and we're going to carefully watch
the butter
melt to make sure that it doesn't burn.
Ew. Whoa!
So once your butter is melted, whether you used stove or microwave, you're going to bring back your graham cracker and sugar mixer, and you're gonna pour the butter in. Then you're going to take a fork and you're just gonna mix it all in until it becomes a wet sand mixture. We're definitely getting a wet sand mixture up in here. It's almost like we're at the beach. That's how wet sand it is.
There were a lot of women that inspired me.
I thought that was funny. Once you have your wet sand like graham cracker mixture, you're gonna put it to the side and we're gonna start zesting and juicing our limes. Usually for this you would use key limes, but those aren't in season, so I got regular limes. We're just going to zest a teaspoon of lime zest. I don't know how to use a zester. Do I just scrape it? I got it. Mom, I don't think I'm doing this right. So apparently I wasn't pushing hard enough on the zester.
Ah! 3 days later.
So after zesting the limes and potentially part of your thumb, you're going to cut the limes in half to prepare them for juicing. We need 3 tablespoons of lime juice. And we're gonna take out this nice juicer and we're just gonna juice. In case you don't know how many limes to buy, 3 to 4 limes should be dandy for all your key lime pie needs. Is there a measuring device on this? Mom, do you know how many ounces are in a tablespoon? Thanks. Blah. This is honestly almost as stress relieving as the smashing of the graham crackers, which is nice after zesting because that is anything but stress relieving. That is stress inducing.
In it from the get-go.
Okay, so that looks like hopefully enough lime juice. If not, we can always get some more. So I'm just going to pour it in this little cup, and then we're just gonna set these to the side. So now we're gonna start to make our key lime pie filling. So we're gonna take this mixing bowl, we're gonna mix 4 ounces of cream cheese, 1/3 cup of condensed milk, and 1 tablespoon of heavy whipping cream. So first we'll start with the cream cheese. Oh, there's measurements on the side. Put cream cheese in. Come on, little buddy. There you go. We need 1/3 cup of condensed milk.
What are you?
An idiot sandwich.
Oh. 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 Yum. Condensed milk. And pour that sucker in there. So after the condensed milk, you're gonna add 1 tablespoon of heavy whipping cream, just like so. So once you have all your ingredients in the mixing bowl, you're going to plug in your mixer and mix for about 3 to 4 minutes. Once you're done mixing, you're going to take 1 teaspoon of your lime zest and put it into the mix, and you're gonna take 3 tablespoons of your lime juice and add that to the mix, and you're just going to mix it around with a scraper and really fold the zest and the juice into the filling. So once you finish making your key lime pie filling, you're gonna take your mason jars and you're going to bring your fun little graham cracker wet sand crust. And we're just going to make a little crust on the bottom of each jar. And we're just gonna take a little spoonful of the crust, put it into each jar, and we're going to pack it down with our fingers. Just make sure you pack it down at the bottom. And then you're just going to add the filling to it enough so that it fills all the way up, like so. Yeah, so here's a little fun tip. Before you overflow the first key lime pie, make sure that you have enough filling for the rest.
If he a clown, I'm a clown too.
So once you have your key lime pie jars full, you're gonna put the lids on and you're gonna refrigerate them for 1 hour. While you're waiting for your key lime pies to freeze in the refrigerator, we're going to make some whipped cream for our topping. So first you're gonna take some heavy whipping cream and you're gonna take 1/3 cup and just pour it in there. Once you put in 1/3 cup of heavy whipping cream, you're gonna put in 2 tablespoons of powdered sugar. And then you're going to take your mixer, your electric mixer again, and you're gonna mix that How do I know when this is good?
Puffy whipped cream.
Well, duh.
And then you should get this puffy whipped cream-like texture. And you're just gonna put that to the side, and when your key lime pies are ready, you're just gonna scoop a little on top. Another thing that we're also going to do while we're waiting for our key lime pies to cool is we're going to chop up another lime just to make a fun little lime garnish to put on top. Finally, you put my love on top. So now we're going to wait for our key lime pies to freeze, and I'll see you then. So when you're ready to eat your key lime pie jar, whether that's after the hour that it needed to refrigerate or whenever you're ready to eat it, you'll take it out of the fridge, you'll get your whipped cream out, which should be refrigerated when you're not using it, and you'll take a scoop of whipped cream, you'll place it on top, and then you'll take a little bit of the graham cracker sugar wet Sam, sprinkle it on top. Take some of the key lime zest, sprinkle that on top, and then you'll take your fun little lime garnish and plop her on the side. And there you have it, a key lime pie in a jar. Let's see how it tastes. Tastes like key lime pie. Are you surprised? I am. Honestly, all the hard work into zesting those limes and this is all I got. Rude. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. If you made these, let me know how it went in the comments below and give a thumbs up if you enjoyed watching me cook. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.